A very good day to all of you. I hope that you remember all that has been taught to you so far. This lesson will be your practice class. As you all know, that for any class on the first day, we learn something new, and on the following day, we practice what we have learned. What you have learned is a very important part of writer, and you can use it later for your office work. Also, whatever more you will be learning is also going to be very useful for you. Let us do some revision before we start the class today. Can you tell why we use alignment? You can use alignment to set your text or paragraph according to your page. You can set your text or paragraph on the left, right, or even in the center of the page. How many types of alignments are there? Alignment is of four types: left, right, center, and justify alignment. Why do we use font color? You can change the color of your text by using font color option. Can you tell what is the difference between highlighting color and background color? While using highlighting color, you get color in the background of the text or paragraph that you have selected. While using background, wherever we keep our cursor on a line or on a paragraph, that part will get colored in the background. What is the shortcut command for making text bold? And what happens when we use the bold option? The shortcut command for bold is Ctrl plus B. And by using the bold option, we can make our text thicker and darker. What is the shortcut command for italics? The shortcut command for italics is Ctrl plus I. All of you now power on your computers and open the writer file. If you face a problem in opening the file, then you can take the help of the video. With the help of this video, today you will learn a new method to open your writer file. As shown in the video, on your desktop, look for the Open Office icon. You can see in the video, it is shown here. Similarly, find this icon on your desktops and with the left button of your mouse or touchpad, click twice on this icon. This is called a double click. Once you do a double click, a window will open as is being shown in the video. This is called a quick start window. And in this, come to the text document. Bring your pointer here and with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, click once on it and your writer file will open. So this is another method of opening the writer file. So let us now get to know what we are going to learn in today's class. Today, all of you will first be typing and then with the help of the formatting toolbar, you will revise various available options like alignment, changing the style of writing, changing the size by making it larger or smaller, changing color of text, bold, italic, underline, etc. Have you all opened the writer file? If you have not been able to open the file, look at the video again. Let us now begin today's lesson. Now look at the paragraph in front of you and type the same on your writer page. After doing this, practice the formatting options as they are told to you one by one. Have you finished typing the paragraph? Let us first practice alignment. All of you set the alignment of the line that you have typed and also share what happens with each of the different alignment options. Now, once again, all of you carefully watch this video and learn more about alignment. In this video, we will learn once again the use of left alignment. So, for left alignment, on your writer page, whenever you start typing text, it is automatically left aligned. As you can see in the video, when you start typing any text, it begins from the left. So it is already left aligned. Also, you should remember that you can do left alignment either before typing the text or after typing the text. Notice that in the video, whatever text we are typing is automatically left aligned. Center alignment helps you to align the text in the center of the writer page. As you can see in the video, the cursor is blinking. Now, you can set the alignment to be center aligned either before typing the text or after typing the text. For setting the center alignment, go to the format bar and click with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad once on this option, and you will see that your cursor starts blinking in the center of the writer page. Now, when you type your text, it will be aligned to the center of the writer page, as is also being shown in the video. So any text that you type is aligned to the center. For doing right alignment, again, you can do right alignment either after typing the text or before typing the text. You have practiced left alignment and center alignment. Now, press enter once and take the cursor or the pointer to the format bar in the option saying align right. Click on that once with the mouse or the touchpad and you will notice that the cursor now starts blinking on the right margin. Any text that you type here goes backwards into the writer page, like is being shown in the video. You can also use Ctrl plus R as the shortcut command. Justify alignment will make all your lines on the writer page appear similar and they will be left aligned. The shortcut command for this is Ctrl plus J. So to do this, first of all, as is being shown in the video, select the text. Then in the format bar, take your pointer to the justify alignment option and click with the left button on the mouse or the touchpad. And you will notice that all your text gets aligned towards the left and all the lines are same. Now all of you delete this text. So, are you all now familiar with how alignment has to be done? We will now learn about font color. Go ahead and everyone select one line using the method taught to you. I am just repeating for clarity. You have to select one line using the methods for selection that you have learned earlier, and then using the option for font color, change the color of the text of that line. Tell your teacher if your font color got changed or not. If you are finding it difficult, watch the video again and learn. In order to change the font color or the color of your writing, you first need to select the line, text or paragraph that you want to change the color of. In the video, you are seeing that we are using the shift and right arrow to select our line or text or the paragraph. So in the video, you can see that we are selecting the text that we want to change the color of the writing of. So we have kept the shift arrow pressed and the right arrow is being pressed one by one to select the text that we want. Once this has been selected, take your cursor to the format bar, look for an A written there, and you will see a small downward arrow, which is the drop down. Click on the drop down and you will see a box opens showing a number of colors. Select the color of your choice that you want the text to appear in and click on that with the left button of your mouse or touchpad, and you will notice that your color of the text that you had selected changes to the desired color. Now, all of you select the next line and with the help of the highlighting color option, highlight the selected line. Those of you who do not know how highlighting is done on a line or paragraph should watch the video, learn how to do it, and then highlight the line that you have selected. In order to highlight the text of our choice, we will first need to select the text or the line or the paragraph that we want to highlight. By doing highlighting, the background color of the writing will change to the desired color that we want. So first, we are selecting the text or the line or the paragraph, and in this video, we are doing so by keeping the shift arrow pressed and using the right arrow one by one to select the text or the line of our choice. You can see in the video, we are selecting the red paragraph for highlighting the color or changing the color in the background of the writing. Once we have selected the text, go to the format bar, look for the AB option, which is for highlighting, and click on the small arrow, downward arrow, which is for the drop down window. Once you click there with your left button on the mouse or the touchpad, a box opens and you can select the color of your choice with which you want to highlight the text. Once you click on that, you will notice that your color of the background of the writing changes. In this picture, an icon is shown with a box. Can you say what is this called? This is the icon for background color, and by using this, you can change the background color. Next, select a line and using this background color option, change the color and tell what happened when you used this option. Remember that you can change the background color of the desired text by selecting the text or even without selecting it. If you face a problem, you should watch the video and learn how to change the background color. Let us now learn about the background color. Notice that the background color also changes the color in the background of the writing. There is a small difference between highlighting color and background color. In highlighting color, whatever text you have selected, the color of the background changes till you have selected the text, till the place where you have selected the text. Background color, you need not select the text, you just need to keep the cursor where you want to change the color of that paragraph or the page. And now bring your cursor to the format bar, to the option of background color, and you will notice a small down arrow. Click on that with the left button of your mouse or touchpad, and you see many colors. Select the color, and you will see that the background color of the paragraph that you had kept the cursor where you had kept the cursor changes. So you can do this either by selecting the text or not selecting the text also. Now, all of you should put bullets and numbering in front of each line of your paragraph. Now, those of you who are not able to understand the use of bullets and numbering option should watch the video and learn its use. Let us now see how we can insert bullets and numbering in our text. So for doing this, you notice that the cursor is blinking in the video as is being shown at the beginning of the paragraph or the text where you want to put the numbering. Now, then go to the format bar and go to numbering option. Click on that with your left button on the mouse or the touchpad, and you will see that the number 1 appears as the first number. And also the numbering and bullets toolbar appears. If you want to bring another bullet or bring another number, then go to the end of the line, take your cursor there and just press enter, and you will notice that another second number appears. If you want to remove the numbering, you can just go to the numbering bar again and click there to remove the number. Next, if you want to insert bullets, take the cursor to the beginning of the line, text or paragraph. Come to the format bar where the bullets option is shown, and you click there with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and you will notice that the bullet appears and also the bullets and numbering bar appears. If you want another bullet after this, take the cursor to the end of the paragraph and press enter, and another bullet appears. If you want to remove the bullet, you just have to go to the bullet option and click there once again. Now, you will revise the first option of the formatting bar. First, show how you can change the style of writing of a line. Now, all of you will be selecting the lines and practicing formatting on those lines. So first, we will practice changing the font color or the font writing. So to do this, you have to first select the line, the text or the paragraph where you want to change the style of your writing. So you see in the video, we are bringing the cursor to the beginning of the line or the text that we want to select. Then we are selecting this line. We go to the format bar, take the cursor there to the drop-down window of the font name and press click on it with your left button or mouse, and you will see many writing styles written there. If you want to see the writing styles which are on the top of this area, you can click on the scroll button and bring it down or up, and then whichever style of writing you select, your selected text gets changed to that writing font, or the font of that text changes. Then in the next line, all of you increase the size of the font and then decrease it and show to your teachers. Watch the video again and learn if you are facing any problems. Next, let us see how we can increase or decrease the size of our writing. we will first take the cursor to the beginning of the line or the text which we want to select, like this, and then we select this particular line as is shown in the video. We bring our cursor to the format bar where it says format font size. Click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and you will see numbers appearing which show the size of the writing. You can scroll up or down and then select the size that you want for your text. Once you click on that with your left button of the mouse or the touchpad, your selected text font size changes. Make the next line bold. Watch the video again and learn if you are facing any problems. Next, let us change the next line to bold. To do this again, we will need to select the text or the line or the paragraph. So we bring the cursor to the beginning of the line, select the area, select the text that we want to make bold, take our cursor or the pointer to the format bar where it says bold. When you click on it, you will notice that your text becomes bold or darker and bigger. Next, all of you change the line's text to italics. If you have any doubts or are still facing a problem, watch and learn from the video. Next, we will change the next line to italics. Again, to do this, we need to select the line, the text or the paragraph. We bring our cursor to the beginning of the line and select these two lines here. Take our cursor to or the pointer to the format bar where it says I, which is the italics option. Click on that with your mouse or touchpad left button, and you will notice that the text that you have selected changes into italics. Next, practice how we underline the desired text. Watch the video again and learn if you face any problems. Next, we will also practice underline. So for that, again we need to select the text or the line or the paragraph. So we take the cursor to the beginning of the line that we want to select, and then we select this line. In fact, we select three lines as is shown in the video. Then we take the cursor or the pointer to the U option in the format bar, which is for underline, and we click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and you will notice that our text gets underlined, or a line appears below that. Since we will be ending today's class now, all of you should close your file, and if you have a doubt about closing files, you must watch the video and learn. In order to close the writer file, so take your pointer or the cursor to the top right corner where there is a cross sign, and click on that with the mouse or the touchpad using the left button. You see three options appearing in a window. Since you do not want to save right now, you can say discard, which is the middle option. Click on that with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad, and your file, writer file, gets closed. Now, shut down the computer properly. In today's lesson, you all have learned about all the options of the formatting bar, like font name, font size, bold, italics, underline, alignment, font color, highlighting color, background color, etc. And along with this, you also did revision of the lessons. Thank you.